Greetings, friends. Welcome again to our weekly devotional at Clearwater Church. This week, we look at our first topic in the series, One Thing, which is One Thing You Lack. In this study, we will see how a young man was living a seemingly righteous life, but still held one thing back from the Lord. So let's learn about that one thing together and examine our hearts for the one thing we may be holding back as well. We find this phrase in Jesus' encounter with the rich young ruler in Mark 10, verses 17 through 31. And the encounter starts with a seemingly genuine question. This young man approached Jesus and said, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" And Jesus' initial reply was as follows. He says, "Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments: do not murder, do not commit adultery, do not steal, do not bear false witness, do not defraud, and honor your father and your mother." Jesus listed off the Ten Commandments, which are the initial building blocks of obedience towards God and our relationship with others. These commandments are non-negotiable and must be followed, although many have broken them. Even some of the great saints in history have had their troubles in keeping these commandments. But this young man countered and said, "Teacher, all these have I kept from my youth." This is a remarkable statement, to say you've kept all of the commandments from your youth, and it should be commended. And so let's take a minute and explore what Scripture says about this man, because on the surface, he looks like he's doing very well. There are two other accounts in the Gospels of Jesus' interaction with this man. Matthew 19, 20, verse 22 says that he was young. Luke 18, verse 18 says that he was a ruler or a leader. And all three accounts agree that he was wealthy. So from a worldly perspective, we see that this young man was doing it well. He was young, successful, and even a leader in some capacity. From a heavenly perspective, we also see that he was earnest. Mark 10:17 said that he came running to Jesus to seek his direction for his life. He also came with humility. It says he came on his knees. He came with reverence and respect. He recognized the lordship of Jesus, even calling him good master. And he was living an honorable life, having kept all of the commandments. And we can see the blessings that were on his life from keeping those commandments. He was blessed with position as a ruler, and he even had natural wealth. So God had been rewarding him for his honorable living. But there was still something that he lacked, and Jesus knew exactly what that one thing was in this man's life. In many of his interactions with people on this earth, Jesus would go right to the root of the issue. In his interactions with the scribes and the Pharisees, he would always point out their hypocrisy. Many offer sacrifices to the Lord or gloat in their faithfulness in serving him, but still hold things back from the Lord. And Jesus was quick to point out that one thing. So Jesus responded to the young man with that one thing and said, "You lack one thing. Go sell all that you have, give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven, and come follow me." Jesus addressed the real issue, the only issue that really mattered. This man may have kept all of the commandments, which is very good, but there was still something that was hindering him from being fully devoted to Jesus, that one thing, and that was his love of riches. Sadly, we read that he was disheartened by the saying. He went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. So this man who was doing well, both from a worldly view and to a certain extent, an outwardly heavenly view, was still missing something. Although he was earnest, humble, and honorable, he was holding something back, and that was his love for his money. So he may have been rich with earthly wealth, but he was not rich towards God. The King James Version says that his countenance fell at Jesus' words because he knew that he could not give up that one thing. If we take a deeper look into this young man, we'll see that his approach was actually all wrong. He was approaching Christ with the attitude of, "What good thing can I do to inherit eternal life?" When in reality, eternal life is not based on works. He wanted to earn salvation by doing good, but as we see here, he loved his money more than he loved the Lord. 1 John 5:21 tells us, "Keep yourselves from idols." This man may not have worshipped a graven image like the pagans did, but he had an idol in his life, and that idol was money. By telling him to give up all his possessions, Jesus was highlighting the one thing that was hindering his goal of eternal life. It's important to point out that Jesus did not want this man's money. He wanted him to give it to the poor. What he wanted was his complete devotion. What he wanted was his whole heart, and he was holding it back. I've heard many people say that money is the root of all evil, but that's not true. 1 Timothy 6:10 says, "For the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil. It is through this craving that some have wandered away from the faith and pierced themselves with many pangs." One of my spiritual mentors had a saying that is a favorite of mine when it comes to money. He said that we were to have Teflon-coated hands. Any wealth that we have comes from the Lord, and it should easily slide out of our hands just as it comes in. He gives it to us, and our main goal is to use that money to further the kingdom of heaven. This man was not willing to part with his wealth, and that was the one thing that kept him from the kingdom of heaven. He tried to possess treasure in both worlds. He tried to have his wealth, but he tried to do things to earn his eternal reward. And he went away from Jesus with great sorrow. Now, you might be watching this and saying, "Well, I'm not rich, so I guess I'm okay." However, the love of money is not the only thing that can keep us from the kingdom of heaven. It is one thing for some people. The question is, what is your one thing? It is between you and the Lord. In reality, anything that we hold on to and love more than the Lord is an idol. So we have to ask the Lord, "What is my one thing?" So the point of this first one thing is that morality alone is not sufficient in God's sight. The rich young ruler was sincere and doing a lot of morally right things that on the surface made him look like he was doing quite well. But he still held back one piece of his heart from the Lord. So as you're watching this, I trust that you were challenged to ask God, "What is my one thing that I lack?" And then give that one thing to him.